Thank you for staying with us on the Pulse Now. Time for the sport. I'm Gary L. Smith. And last week, we did get news that the Black Queens had done the first part of the job. They are looking to qualify for the Olympic Games, Tokyo 2020. And as part of preparations, they had to go to Gabon and get a win. They did that with flying colors. They won by 3-0. The second leg will be this week in Accra. It will actually be tomorrow. But today they are training at the Accra Sports Stadium, and we'll be getting updates from there. Benedict Owusu is on the line for us to give us an update on what's going on and what we should expect from the Queens ahead of their game in 24 hours.
So you're welcome to the Accra Sports Stadium, where the Black Queens are training ahead of their game tomorrow against Gabon. As you can see behind me, that's the Gabonese ladies also training ahead of that game tomorrow. It's the second leg of the Olympic qualifier. The first leg was away in Libreville, which Ghana won by 3-0. Portia Boache, Juliet Ichampon, and Priscilla Boache were the goal scorers for Ghana, of course. I mean, with it been very long since Ghana played at the games. I'm talking about the Olympic Games in the women's football. These set of players, as well as Mercy Tego, will be hoping to qualify for the games. But the road is very long. I mean, this is just the second round of the qualifiers. They have the third round to play, fourth round, and then a fifth round. And as you know, with the qualifiers, only one African team will qualify, and then the playoff will come. Where Ghana will play against, if Ghana is able to make it to that point, we'll play against a CONMEBOL opponent to make the games. So two teams from the continent will qualify, but one will qualify from this very qualifiers that they are playing. And as I mentioned, the road is very long. It's just the second round that they are. They didn't play in the first round, so they are in the second round. If they're able to cross this hurdle, which we are all hoping they will go to the third round, fourth, and then the fifth round. Well, I've got some lovely ladies here to help me do the discussion in terms of getting a perspective from the Black Queens' point of view, because, I mean, that's what we all want. The last time we participated at a football event at the Olympic Games was in Athens 2004. That wasn't even the ladies, it was the men's team. So it's been a while since we had the opportunity to play in the Olympic Games. My dear sister Aisha, I hope I got it right.
Yes.
Okay, you do the introduction. You say your name.
My name is Aisha Tali Zakaria. I work with Tap FM.
Nice. So, I mean, you've been following the Black Queens. I remember you were with them in Ivory Coast. Unfortunately, that tournament, we couldn't win. But, I mean, the little that you've seen of these ladies, do we have the best of team not to worry about this Gabonese team?
I mean, personally, following the girls and then being with them during the WAFU tournament, I think that this is the best players that we have. People may disagree with the fact that there are not a lot of foreign-based players in it, but I'm saying that, listen, this is what we have, and then the coach is working with it. I mean, when we went to the WAFU tournament, we went with basically players that most people didn't know. I mean, the AMA players were not there, the Portia Boache were not there, and then the likes, but they were able to win bronze. So with the current team that they have, I mean, Portia is back, Priscilla Ochoa is back. So obviously, this is the best team that we have currently. So I am hopeful, and I know that tomorrow it will be an easy game for them because they won 3-0. It's not easy to go away and they win with that margin. And the fact that they are coming to play at the Accra Sports Stadium, obviously nothing can go wrong.
All right, so I told you I was going to interact with two lovely ladies. Well, Nah, please complete the name for me.
Okay, my name is Nah Badina.
Okay.
And then I work for NB Sports.
All right, so you're also a follower of the Black Queens team. 3-0 away. Daniel?
You can't say that because this is football. And speaking with the Black Queens coach, she told us that it wasn't as if the match was easy for them. They have some quality players among them. It's due to one or two mistakes, which if you don't make mistakes in football, you will not even score. And that is why they had those goals. And think so tomorrow they will probably be doing all that it will take for them to win that game. I'm not going to say it's going to be an easy game for the Black Queens.
But if you had to predict, of course, what would you say?
Definitely we should run away with at least the same goal margin or more.
All right, so she feels that, of course, maybe we can win by 3-0. But Aisha, what do you also think? We won 3-0 away. Your sister here says it's not a done deal. We still have a lot of work to do. You share the same sentiment?
No, I disagree. I mean, this is the Black Queens of Ghana. If you watch the players, if you watch... Yes, I mean, I know. But the issue is that the fact that you can win 3-0 away, I mean mistakes happen in football, and football is not predictable, you can't predict, but the fact that you can win 3-0 is that obviously you can actually win at more than 3. I don't expect Gabon to even get a goal here, honestly. 4-5-3, more than 3.
All right, so more than 3, the discussion is getting interesting. Let me bring in my sister Akusi. Akusi, come. Na says we are winning same margin as we did away, and Aisha thinks that we win more than 4, right? Yeah. What do you also think?
This should be an easy win for the Black Queens, honestly. I mean, some people would want to judge them basically on their last performance that we also during the Alcon, but they are not as bad as that. Remember, during the Alcon, we're playing with the best. And when we are talking about the best in Africa, Gabon, they are not one of the best at this particular moment. You check their FIFA ranking and everything, we are way ahead of them. And it's not going to be a case of probably them turning into Madagascar all of a sudden and coming here to do something that we don't expect from them. And so we have gathered the best. And I know that the Queens are going to be able to win against these Gabonese.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate your time. Thank you so much. Thank you. So, of course, you've heard it. You have no reason not to be here at the Accra Stadium tomorrow to cheer the Black Queens to victory. It's the Olympic Games qualifier. And as you saw, or as you can see, the Gabonese team training, the Black Queens will come in pretty surely to also train ahead of the game tomorrow. My name is Benedict Osu. Thanks so much. And we'll be here, and we expect all of you to be here to support the ladies to victory. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Benedict, for your time and for that update from the Accra Sports Stadium. So that's the wrap. Tomorrow, game kicks off at 3 p.m. Will you be there? If you won't, we will be your eyes and ears. I'm Gary Al Smith from the studio.